And there we go, Xbox, live at E3, the press conference, lots of news and announcements. Jeff Keighley here. I was actually over at the Microsoft Theater right behind there watching. I still got my badge here. But now we are here for our post-show, reacting to all things Xbox. We've got a great panel. This is day one of YouTube Live at E3, and this is hour four. So Microsoft's press conference is over. We've got Bethesda later tonight with Rage 2. You saw a little bit of Fallout 76 on stage, but right now, let's get to our panel, because joining me again are Boogie and Angry Joe, as well as some new faces from Outside Extra. We've got Ellen Rose and the game theorist himself, Matt Pat. Guys, let's get right into it. Xbox, Joe and Boogie were with us before, telling us what they were expecting. But Matt, Ellen, let's start with you guys. What did you think overall? What did Xbox have to do today in your eyes, and did they do it?
I think Xbox really had to, I mean, this is very clearly kind of an interim year, yeah. I think, for everyone, right? Last year, there was a lot of the Xbox One 4K gaming and a lot of big titles. This year is kind of like a down year, and so I was really curious what they would announce that would get people excited. And I think they hit a lot of stuff, but it feels to me there are things that are either happening coming out like immediately or coming out in early 2019.
Yep.
I don't know what the releases are between kind of like
end
of summer.
The big holiday game.
Yeah, I don't know what the big holiday game is this year. And I'm still waiting for that, quite honestly.
Good point, Matt Pat. And what was your take?
They've bought all the studios because a big thing is that they've not had a lot of first-party games. Yep. Like PlayStation's kind of been absolutely killing it with Horizon Zero Dawn and things like that last year, God of War this year, and they really needed to, you know, kick it out of the park with this one. And I think, you know, they've gone, look, we're investing in all these studios. These games are all going to come to Xbox, Game Pass, you can go play it. It's quite exciting.
It is. No, that's what I will say is I think there's a lot of, they're reinvigorated. There's a lot of momentum there. They're investing. It's not, you know, a lot of people are wondering, well, is Xbox, are they going to, you know, PlayStation's doing so well, are they going to pull back? It feels like they're kind of reinvesting, which is great, but it's going to take a couple of years for those studios to bring anything out. So, Joe, let's go to you. First of all, you got your Cyberpunk, so that's you were giddy.
I was freaking out, dude. Yeah, so it looks amazing. It looks cinematics, right? Not like a gameplay demo yet. Yeah. It's still kind of early, I guess, but from what I saw, amazing visual design. The world is so rich there, and you're taking really great developer, CD Projekt Red. I just can't wait. But
overall, though, what did you think? Because coming in, you were saying they you know, it was make it or break it for Xbox. Joe was about to throw out his Xbox before.
Extreme.
I haven't turned the thing on since Cuphead.
Well, there's more Cuphead coming.
So break it down for it.
There was some good and bad. The investment. I really like the investment. They seem committed, but I just don't understand why this wasn't done before. But okay, we're doing it now, right?
Yep.
They showed Halo Infinite. But they didn't tell me what it was. They didn't show me more.
Right.
Is that a battle royale? Please don't tell me that's a battle royale.
I guarantee it has a battle royale.
I was thinking there wasn't much mention of battle royale at all on stage.
I'll give some credit where credit is due. It does look like they're trying to reinvest in the games. They can 50 games, 18 exclusives, but by the end, I felt like, just like Matt here, that there's not much, where is the next exciting thing?
Yeah.
You got your Halo, you got your Gears.
Yep.
Not just Gears, but Gears upon Gears upon Gears.
I don't think so.
Did you say anything about when it's coming out for Gears?
No.
For Gears 5?
Because they are eventually going to make it.
Well, don't worry. In the meantime, you have Gears Pop, so that's exciting.
They showed a little Gears 5. I think I don't know if they said when that was coming out, but you're right. Like for this holiday, there's not that big game. So are you keeping your Xbox, Joe?
I think the show overall was disappointing, but they
had
to be
Xbox?
Because they are investing.
Yeah, right? That's what it
is. So next year we're probably going to get this big payoff, but. I'll keep it for right now, Jeff. You put me on the spot.
The cop out, Joe. Come on. You said it was good. You're making a decision.
No, it wasn't good. It wasn't a good show.
2019. I think if you get to 2019, I think that's when that investment really is going to start to pay off. If it doesn't pay off in 2019, then you can throw it away.
All it was
understand.
Was world premieres, though, on multi-platform titles. I didn't feel like I needed to buy that Xbox One X.
No, that's true for some of those games, and I don't, you know, we'll have to break it down. Aaron Greenberg's going to be here, but I imagine, like, some of the games we saw, Cyberpunk, some of the other ones, they're going to be coming to PlayStation as well.
Yeah.
I'm so confused by their messaging this year, because I don't really understand what the message is.
Console launch exclusive, there was world premiere, there was
exclusive.
But, like, we're 5 years into a generation, but we just bought a bunch of studios, but that's what you do prior to a new generation.
Yeah.
Is this ramping up for the next generation or the next iteration?
Next
Xbox. Are you just making promises for the next Xbox?
Good
or
point.
What are you doing there?
Yeah.
And then all the usual stuff was there, and I'm glad.
Yeah.
Forza 4 looks incredible, Horizon 4.
Yeah.
I don't like the base Forza series, but the Horizon series is incredible.
Yeah. Hmm.
Give me, you know, a lake that freezes over and give
more
me
more action oriented.
It sounds amazing, right?
Yeah.
And the multiplayer is the best part of the Forza Horizon series, so I'm so excited about that. It's so much cringe too, like gears pop. What is happening?
France is not happy about that.
Oh,
the crowd got, the crowd was like, woo, and then they were like, oh.
If you listened really quietly, you could hear Cliff Bleszinski throw up in his mouth a little bit somewhere. Like, but then they promised Gears 5 at the end of it.
Right.
And then I even like, I was kind of cringy with the Gears Mobile, but then I checked Cliff's feed and he's like, that's something we always wanted to do, was a Gears Tactics game. So. I'm trying to stay positive.
It just dilutes a little bit, though, the fact you're going to announce Gears 5. It was weird to me that you start with, like, this pop game.
Right.
To me, it's like, if it's a reveal
it's
the
direct.
Next Gears, it should be epic and all about that. And it's like, and by the way, we have a pop
game. I like how
they
drop the war. It's just Gears.
Yeah.
Gears 5. It's,
Gears 5.
Right. I will say, I think
we all call it
the
Gears.
War, the war
War's
is over.
Exactly.
All that matters are the
Gears.
Exactly.
Ranking the
Gears. The real messaging here that really hits home for me is Game Pass is the best thing that they are doing.
Yeah.
They don't really have a console selling title.
Yeah.
But Game Pass
access,
is such a stupidly good value that if you go to a used game store and pick up a box and we're giving you all of our exclusives and all of our first party games, all for technically free, $10 a month. Yeah. I think they're selling Game Pass is like $30 a year right now. It's a console seller, and I think if they really drive home that message, it makes people go out and buy a console to get access to all of these games technically for close to free.
Yeah.
And they're leading the Netflix model. Like PlayStation Now doesn't really work. It's just not great.
I gotta push back on you there,
okay.
Boogie, because like I saw EA and their push towards Origin.
Yeah.
Obviously, you know, the Microsoft subscription now. I worry that we're entering this phase in gaming where you don't actually own the games that you're paying for. And like that to me is something that is really hard to swallow.
Locked
And I get the value of like, look at you get this whole library of games, you get to play them as much as you want, but then like if I want to move away, I have nothing, right?
Yeah.
Like you are stuck in this perpetual treadmill where you're paying for something and you don't actually own it.
Like you must buy all your music, man.
And I do. I buy my music.
No Spotify.
I wonder how it affects game design as well, because if you know you're creating a first-party game, before we went live, I talked about how Xbox is all about games as a service, microtransactions, and expansions to their games, and we see that with Destiny, and we see that with a lot of EA games. We see it with the sports titles. If you're launching a game for free, you're not taking in that $60 initial hit like they did with Sea of Thieves, you're going to be so tempted to put pay-to-play or things to upsell in your games.
Yeah.
So I will always worry about that.
Yeah.
That's one of the biggest issues. If you're giving away everything for free, you've got to make your money somewhere.
I was hoping to be blown away with this one, and it didn't quite blow me away.
Yeah.
Because
they had new Halo, new Gears, you know, those are big news, but you're right. You said before, I think it's like you wanted to have that big new IP that Microsoft's investing in. And, you know, we like there's Battletoads
first
and other
party,
stuff. But first party. And we didn't get that.
Battletoads is going to look great in 4K. Like, that is the game that you're getting the 4K console for.
HDR, obviously. 4K.
Yeah, it's right, like, 60 where it's frames like, per second.
I hope that game is going to be as difficult as you told me. The Badge of Honor, you completed the game.
To this day, beating the original Battletoads on the NES is, like, one of my highest gamer achievements. And I hope that they still stay true to that, just impossibly difficult,
Completely unironic. Ironically, I am fully into a Battletoads like remake, or not even remake, but a sequel. Like, I love that game growing up. I love the arcade version. I have a retro arcade in my hometown. We'll go there and play it together. It's harder with multiplayer. The more players you have, the worse it is.
Yeah.
And just to take me back to that. Plus, it's rage gamer bait. Like, me and Joe are going to have to talk about the game. We're going to live stream and break controllers. So it's just a natural fit.
No, that was good, but I agree there wasn't that one thing, Joe, that you can hang your hat on. It's like, this is the bold new IP from first-party studios.
It is interesting, though. I think the announcement that they were able to scoop up Kingdom Hearts away from Sony.
No, it's coming. It's coming to PlayStation 2.
It's not exclusive. That's interesting.
Some people saw that online. Like, I think it was announced it was coming to Xbox for 4 because they had an event about a month ago. But they have the marketing partnership, I assume, whereas it used to always be associated with PlayStation, very heavily Sony branded. You're right. The last one was, you know, obviously all Sony. But this one, both platforms, is a big deal.
I love exclusives when you're putting money into a brand new IP and creating something that doesn't exist. And you can only play it because we are the ones who paid it. We're the ones who paid for it. Yeah. Never really understood why, you know, Kingdom Hearts was exclusively on PlayStation. So more people getting to play it, Xbox fans getting to play it. I welcome that.
Yeah, I can't wait to play it.
Incredible series.
I've never played it, man. And how is it? I really haven't. Okay, everybody's freaking out on me here. No, I'm serious. I've never played it.
Wow.
In fact, I thought it was turn-based.
Oh, she's freaking out right now.
So that's okay. That's chain of memories.
I want to play it. I want to play it. This one looks inviting to me, especially with all these new licenses they brought in.
I got
them in Star Wars too and Marvel. Are they doing any of that?
Ratatouille. All right, so let's wrap it up here with some grades. A, B, C, D, E, F. Well, how would you guys grade the Xbox press conference overall? Let's start with you.
Gladly give it a solid C.
A solid C.
They didn't make any mistakes. They didn't screw up. There was nothing cringeworthy. I'm not mad about anything. Francis is calm and okay.
You know Francis video?
Maybe just for Gears Pop alone, but nothing upsetting, and I mean, nothing really to be excited about either. But the promise of, we bought a bunch of studios, we've heard what you said, we're going to start working on the single player games that you need, that you want. Yeah. It's coming. I don't know when. It might be the very last year of the generation, but it's coming.
Okay. So. Joe, what's your grade?
Well, like I said, they for this conference, a little weak, but they're planting that seed. I can see the seed being planted now. I'm mad the seed wasn't there already and coming to fruition, but they're planting the seed. But again, nothing too exciting. You know, Halo and Gears, little worn out. Need that first party title, something excited around the holiday. No, it seems like February is turning into Broketober, but for Brokeuary.
Yeah, right.
So, I think. Probably about on par with last year because they showed so many games. They made it about the games. They said we're going to invest. So 6 out of 10 again.
Well, but we got to go letters. Yeah, so that's like.
I'm C.
D? Oh,
you know, C.
Okay.
Yeah.
A C from Joe. All right.
Wow. Okay, I'm going to be nice and give them a B.
Okay.
Because I was excited for new Cuphead, new Ori.
Yeah.
Excited that they got to show to the world that Arendelle is going to be in Kingdom Hearts, which I am super excited about.
Okay.
And I think, as Joe said, they are planting the seed. They are getting all of that stuff ready so that next year they'll hopefully come out, you know, swinging and it'll be great. They really are about investing, especially like the IDEA Xbox titles. Yep. There's a lot of love there. I'm looking forward to seeing We Happy Few. Yep. It looks like an actual game now.
Fun game. I played it about a month ago. It's cool.
Has it been released like 3 times at this point? I keep waiting for
many
it.
Years.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Many years. All right, Matt.
I gotta agree with the B.
Okay.
Yes, it's kind of lacking in what is the big holiday release. But it's hard to really knock a conference that really brought up, hey, there's going to be a new Halo. Hey, there's going to be a new Gears. Hey, look, we have access to Kingdom Hearts now. There's going to be a new Battletoads. There's going to be a new expansions to Cuphead. And we bought all of these other studios. We're eating them up before EA can eat them up.
Yeah.
And so, like, I'm excited to see kind of what's coming up. Like you said, in February of 2019, I think that there's going to be enough to hold us over until we get a huge rush next year.
All right, well, we'll see. So overall, solid. You said not spectacular, not super disappointing. It was a solid, safe press conference from Microsoft with some good stuff.
To me, on what Halo Infinite turns out to be, because I do know the original design, and Bernie discussed this before we walked away,
so
the original design for Halo was an open world experience, and if that's what they're bringing, that could be, I mean, that's the deal breaker, right? That is the console
I'd rather have that
than 10 million, 10 million consoles overnight.
Yeah.
You know?
All right. Okay. Well, a lot of high stakes. High stakes there, Boogie. All right. If only Boogie could fix things at Xbox. If only you could run Xbox, Boogie. All right. Well, thank you very much, guys, for joining us. Great stuff. Now it's time.